गुड मॉर्निंग बच्चों, टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन ऑफ डीएनए। और ठीक डीएनए इज डीऑक्सीराइबोज न्यूक्लिक एसिड। It is present in nucleus of the cell and it is surrounded with the histone protein in chromosome. Here just chemical composition of DNA you will see. It is made up of four type of bases: adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine, deoxyribose sugar and phosphate. Adenine and thymine bind with each other by double hydrogen bond. Guanine, cytosine bind with each other by triple hydrogen bond. Thymine adenine with double hydrogen bond. Here base bind with sugar by N glycosidic bond. Here also this base bind with sugar by N glycosidic bond, and the sugar bind with phosphate by phosphodiester bond. So base and base, adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine. Adenine, thymine bind with each other by double hydrogen bond. Guanine, cytosine bind with triple hydrogen bond. Base, adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine, these are the base. Base are bind with sugar up its side by N glycosidic bond, and sugar bind with phosphate by phosphodiester bond. So this way, by these bond, hydrogen bond, N glycosidic bond and phosphodiester bond, the base, sugar and phosphate are arranged in such a way they form DNA. And the nature of DNA, character which is important in the DNA, is depend upon this base sequence which is present in DNA. So the DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. The double helical structure of DNA was given by double helical structure of DNA was given by J.D. Watson and F.S.C. What is the double helical structure of DNA? Let us see. In the double helical structure of DNA, here is the helix of DNA. Two helix, double helical means two helix, and this helix runs antiparallel to each other. This is one helix. And this is one helix. Here this is in 5 to 3 direction, and this will be again 5 to 3 direction. These are the two helix. These two helix are made up of sugar phosphate. Here one helix, this one helix made up of deoxyribose sugar and phosphate. Here also another helix made up deoxyribose sugar and phosphate. So these helix are made up of deoxyribose sugar and phosphate by phosphodiester sugar, and phosphate bind with phosphodiester bond, then form one side of helix, and here sugar and deoxyribose sugar and phosphate bind with phosphodiester bond to form other helix. In between those two helix, here bases, adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine. Means here adenine represented, bases are, here what is present? Deoxyribose sugar, that is represented by S. Phosphate represented by P. Sugar represented by S. Phosphate represented by P. And bases are, suppose, purine and pyrimidine. So purine contain two type. What is two type? Here is adenine. Adenine is represented by A. What I have written A. Other one is guanine. Guanine is represented by G. I have written here G. And this pyrimidine contain two type. What is thymine? This thymine thymine represented by T, and now cytosine. Cytosine represented by C. So this total DNA is composed of deoxyribose sugar, phosphate, deoxyribose sugar, phosphate, and bases purine, pyrimidine. The purine consists of two bases, adenine, guanine. Adenine is represented by A, capital A. Guanine represented by capital G. Pyrimidine consists of thymine, cytosine. Thymine is represented by capital T, and cytosine represented capital C. So in the DNA, adenine of purine bind with thymine of pyrimidine, and guanine of purine bind with cytosine of pyrimidine. You see, the adenine is the part of purine bind with thymine is the part of pyrimidine. So adenine bind with thymine, adenine bind with thymine, and guanine the part of purine bind with cytosine is the part of pyrimidine. So this way, adenine bind with thymine by double hundred bond, guanine bind with cytosine by triple hundred bond. Means adenine bind with thymine by double hundred bond, guanine bind with cytosine by triple hundred bond. Or guanine is bind with cytosine by triple hundred bond, and thymine is bind with adenine by double hundred bond. So this way, this bond formation occur. But these bases, thymine T, thymine bind with sugar by N-glycosidic bond. Similarly, cytosine bind with sugar apicite by N-glycosidic bond. Adenine bind with sugar by N-glycosidic bond. Guanine bind with sugar by N-glycosidic bond. Apicite here also N-glycosidic bond. And the both sugar are bind with phosphorus by phosphodiester bond. So here the sugar and phosphate form this helix, apicite, sugar and phosphate form helix, and the bases are present here inside. So let us see the bases. Where are the bases? Here adenine by double bond with thymine. Adenine by double bond with thymine, and here guanine with triple bond by cytosine. So here these are bind with this bond, and here again here you can say again here thymine will bind with sequence can change, no problem. Sequence can change, but always adenine will bind with thymine, or thymine will bind with adenine, and cytosine will bind with guanine by triple hundred bond. This bonding nature will be the same. Sequence can change. Here the distance between these two coils in the DNA is 3.4 nm, nanometer. And here between these two, how many these bases are present? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10. And distance between these two, base pair, means these two base pair, is about 0.34 nm. Means here, this entire the sequence contains 10 base pair between 2.34. If you will multiply with 0.34 into 10, then 3.4 it will come. And the diameter from here to here, what is the diameter of this? Diameter of this is about 2 nm. 2 nm. And both helix runs anti-parallel. This is parallel. Anti-parallel means just opposite. Here 5 to 3 direction, and this is 5 to 3 direction. So anti-parallel of each other. So what I told, the DNA is double helical structure. Double helical model of DNA was given by Watson and Crick. They got Nobel Prize for this. And here in the DNA, the helix, double helix are, both helix are made up of sugar and phosphate, deoxyribose sugar and phosphate. And the both helix are bind with each other by this bond with the certain bases. Here, adenine bind with thymine with double hundred bond, guanine bind with cytosine with triple hundred bond, and the sugar deoxyribose sugar bind with phosphodiester bond. Base bind with sugar with N-glycosidic bond. Again, let us see. Base adenine thymine bind with double hundred bond, guanine cytosine bind with triple hydrogen bond. Base and sugar bind with N-glycosidic bond, and the sugar and phosphate bind with phosphodiester bond.
two, three types of bond are here. The hydrogen bond, where between bases, and N-glycosidic bond, N-glycosidic bond between sugar and base, and phosphodiester bond between sugar and phosphate. So DNA is composed of these chemical which are bind with different bond. Base and base bind with adenine, thymine, double end bond, guanine, cytosine, triple header bond. Base and sugar with N-glycosidic bond, and the sugar and phosphate with phosphodiester bond. Thus, the double helical model of DNA was given by the J.T. Watson and F.A.C. Crick here. Now, DNA is polynucleotide. DNA is polynucleotide. DNA is polynucleotide. Polynucleotide means nucleotide N. Nucleotide N. Large number of nucleotide. It is made up of large number. Suppose base sugar phosphate one nucleotide, base sugar phosphate other nucleotide, base sugar phosphate other nucleotide, base sugar phosphate other nucleotide. So large number of nucleotide are here, then it is polynucleotide. And each nucleotide is composed of nucleoside plus phosphate. So phosphate is here, phosphate and nucleoside kya hai? Base plus sugar kya ho gaya? Nucleoside. Means this and this is nucleoside and this phosphate, nucleoside plus phosphate. Nucleoside is what? Nucleoside means the base plus sugar. Sugar means pentose sugar. Here is the pentose sugar. So this pentose sugar and base, this is nucleoside, and nucleoside plus phosphate nucleotide means this and this nucleoside and this is phosphate, then this nucleotide. So base sugar phosphate nucleotide and base and sugar is nucleoside. Nucleoside and phosphate nucleotide. And base, jab abhi humne bola base kya hai, base do tarah ke, purine aur pyrimidine. Purine mein kaun kaun the? In purine, adenine, इसको A से represent किया, फिर guanine, याद रखना है, ये किसका हिस्सा है, purine का हिस्सा adenine, guanine, नीट में भी पूछा जाता है, pyrimidine का क्या है, thymine and cytosine, इसी को हमने represent किया है. यहाँ एडिनिन को ए से, थायमिन को टी से, ग्वानिन को सी से, ग्वानिन को जी से, साइटोसिन को सी से. तो प्यूरिन का एडिनिन पायरिमिडिन के थायमिन से डबल हेड बॉन्ड से, पायरिमिडिन प्यूरिन का ग्वानिन पायरिमिडिन के साइटोसिन ट्रिपल हेड बॉन्ड से बधेगा, तब जाके बॉन्ड बनेगा. अब बेस सुगर से किससे बधेगा, एन ग्लाइकोसिडिक बॉन्ड से बताया था, और सुगर और फास्फेट फास्फोडाइएस्टर बॉन्ड से. सो बेस और सुगर न्यूक्लियोसाइड and nucleoside and phosphate nucleotide, or large number of nucleotide, then polynucleotide means this is the DNA. This is chemical structure of DNA. This is chemical composition of DNA. Chemical composition of DNA. Up. The length of DNA depend upon number of base sugar and phosphate. If number of base sugar and phosphate will increase, then length of the DNA will be more. And if it is less, then the DNA length will be less. The part of DNA which is responsible for one trait,
that is called a gene. It means DNA is consists of large number of genes. So many genes are present in DNA. Means the small part of DNA which is responsible for one trait, that is called a gene. Suppose in Navodaya Vidyalaya, there are so many classrooms, lab, office. All will unite, then it is Navodaya. If all will be separated, where is Navodaya? So similarly, Navodaya is the composition of the several classrooms, lab, laboratory, and the office, and the hostel, house, mess, all these. So similarly, the part of DNA, the small part of DNA, which is responsible for one trait, that is called as one gene. That is responsible for particular one trait. And entire DNA have large number of genes, which are responsible for different traits. This way, the DNA is the blueprint of body design. This is the structure of DNA. Now, function of DNA. What is the function of DNA? DNA is the central dogma of molecular biology. DNA is the central dogma of molecular biology. How DNA is the central dogma of molecular biology? Suppose here is the DNA. This DNA undergo replication. DNA undergo replication to produce similar type of DNA. When this DNA undergo transcription, then produce RNA. Undergo transcription to produce RNA, and undergo translation to synthesize protein. So in our body, protein are synthesizing, then we are growing. Hormone, enzyme are synthesizing. All the synthesis depend upon the structure of DNA. DNA can produce similar type of DNA, that is called a replication. When one DNA, suppose from here helix will open, here helix will open, each old helix will produce new helix. So one DNA produce two DNA, this is called a replication. But DNA undergo transcription produce RNA are different types. RNA, mRNA, and tRNA, ribosomal RNA, messenger RNA, transfer RNA. So these are the different type of RNA which are synthesized by that during the transcription of DNA. DNA transcript the RNA, mRNA, tRNA. Now this RNA, mRNA, tRNA play important in synthesis of protein. Protein synthesized, then the cell membrane develops, then cell organelle develop, then the cell number will increase, then the separate size of the organism will increase. So without DNA, this is not possible. So DNA produce own type of DNA, it is called a replication. DNA produce RNA, that is called a transcription. DNA regulate the synthesis of protein with the help of RNA, that is called a translation. So this DNA is central dogma of molecular biology. DNA is central dogma of molecular biology. Any type of molecule are going to synthesize. That its synthesis is governed and regulated by DNA with the help of RNA. Then protein means molecule are going to synthesize. So what is the function of DNA? DNA undergo replication to produce similar type of DNA. DNA undergo transcription to produce RNA and translate protein. DNA is genetic material, blueprint of body design. If any change in the base sequence of DNA occurs, then the body design may change. Suppose you are writing S-O-N, sun. Sun means beta. But by mistake, one student will write S-U-N. So sense will change. S-U-N, sun means sun. So at the place of O, U will be there, then sense will change. Similarly, at the place of A, other base will come, then sequence will change, then nature of that codon will change, then amino acid will change, then protein will change. So it is depend upon the sequence of bases. So DNA contain the sequence of bases. That sequence of bases contain the blueprint of body design, and according to sequence of bases, here RNA is going to produce, and according to sequence of RNA, mRNA codon, protein is going to synthesize. So DNA is the central dogma of molecular biology. DNA is the genetic material. इन द सर्टेन ऑर्गेनिज्म आरएनए इज आल्सो जेनेटिक मटेरियल जस्ट लाइक इन सम वायरस एचआईवी वायरस दैट कंटेन आरएनए जेनेटिक मटेरियल बट दिस बैक्टीरियोफेज वायरस इज कंटेन डीएनए जेनेटिक मटेरियल इन अदर प्लांट एंड एनिमल डीएनए इज जेनेटिक मटेरियल एंड डीएनए प्रोड्यूस आरएनए लाइक आरएनए राइबोसोमल आरएनए मैसेंजर आरएनए ट्रांसफर आरएनए देन रेगुलेशन सिंथेसिस ऑफ प्रोटीन सो इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन डीएनए एंड आरएनए थैंक यू वेरी मच